Hi, I'm Ben Lucas, and welcome to Monday Morning Morsel, the video series where we talk everything photographers. I want to give you tutorials and discussion topics in bite-sized pieces. So today, we're talking backups. Don't you just hate it when this happens? So today we're talking backups. Apparently Bjorn is going to assist me today. Bjorn, say hello to the people. Bjorn. Hi. Show of hands, who's ever lost a hard drive? I know I have. If you're not raising your hand right now, you're either lying to me or you're probably not old enough to be on YouTube by yourself. But for the rest of us, I'm going to be talking about two different backup methods that you can use. One of them's easy and the other one is bulletproof. So let's start with the easy one. The easy one is Backblaze. There's a link in the doobly-doo where you can sign up and get some extra free months. It is $5 a month, or if you want to pay in bulk, $3 a month. You just seriously cannot go wrong with that. The thing that I love about Backblaze is it happens automatically in the background and you never have to do anything. You never have to think about it. But then when something does go wrong, your hard drive crashes, your laptop gets stolen, your apartment gets set on fire. All of these things have happened to clients of mine and I've had to resend them their files. This is just stuff that happens. Backblaze would save your bacon here. It would save your photos, stop you from losing any data. How it works is you go onto their site, you request a backup drive. It usually takes 2 or 3 days for them to send that to you, but then you have a drive with all of your data on it. You send them the drive back, they'll refund the money for that drive. So it is free backups. It is just the $3 a month that you paid for the subscription service. Any other backups on top of that are free. I think in the past 8 years, I've used this 4 different times. It's really excellent. They are not paying me to say this. I just really love this service and think everyone should have it. Anytime family, friends, mom, sister, anyone who has a laptop and is like, oh no, it crashed. I lost all my stuff. What do? Get Backblaze. Okay, enough gushing about that. For the ones that are looking for something just a little bit more bulletproof, here's the system that I actually use for my photography. So here we are at my computer. I've got last week's thumbnail and a little something-something that I'm working on. So what's the first thing that you have to do when you get home from a shoot? You have all these memory cards, and then those memory cards have to be put onto your computer. I put them onto my Synology drive, which is tucked away right there. I have an 8-bay Synology drive with a 2-drive redundancy. Now, what that means is there are 8 drives in there. 6 of them are usable data space. 2 of them are redundancy. So any 2 drives can fail. Any 2 of the 8. And I'm still okay. As long as 3 drives don't fail at the same time, I'm still okay. Don't ask me the technicals of how it works. If I would have had a computer science degree, I would have worked at Adobe. Hashtag true story. So when my photos are done and they're ready to come off of the Synology drive, they actually get put onto these drives right here. So now I actually just use internal hard drives as external drives because they're cheaper. You can get them for about $30 a terabyte. And then you can get these boxes to keep them nice, safe, and dust free. So currently on my desk, I have archive 2.1 and 3.1. I also have a 2.2 and 3.2 because I have 2 copies of every single hard drive. The first copy stays here, so I can always access it if I ever need anything. And the second one goes to a fire safe at a family member's house. One copy of those drives, it doesn't matter which one because they are duplicate, one copy of that actually gets plugged in and backed up to Backblaze. So Backblaze has unlimited backups for hard drives. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't support NAS devices such as the Synology drive. There are other backup systems that support that, but they get really pricey really quick. So I've actually found Backblaze is just fine for me. The Synology drive itself is a great working drive. As I'm doing stuff, I'm never gonna lose any data because it has that triplicate backup system. But once something goes to the archive, I have two copies of that, physical copies of that, and then a third physical copy in the cloud in the form of Backblaze. Hopefully that was easy enough for you guys to follow, but let me give you the conclusion summary really quick. So you do a shoot and all your photos are on your memory cards. Those memory cards get copied to the Synology drive. The Synology drive then copies it to three different hard drives. Again, two of those hard drives can fail. As you're working, you have those triplicate copies. When the job is done and you're ready to archive, then it gets copied to two different physical hard drives, and one of those physical copies gets uploaded to Backblaze. Now, here's the thing with Backblaze, it happens automatically. You don't actually have to do anything to copy it. The only caveat is that it does have to be plugged in once every 30 days, which usually isn't a problem for me because I'm doing so many tutorials. Literally, all you have to do is plug it in, give it 5 to 10 seconds to connect. It'll say, yep, you still have this hard drive, and then you put it back. It's that easy. The reason why Backblaze does this is because they are not a storage system. You do have to have the hard drive. They're just backing up your data. That is my backup system. It's pretty bulletproof, and there are no delays in my workflow if something bad does happen. And if you're a professional photographer, then these things are really important and it's worth the cost. It might seem a little crazy, but trust me, there are some crazier, way more expensive backup systems. This one is on the cheap if you actually look up some other photographers. I've seen Chase Jarvis's backup system and it's just... Thank you so much for watching. Like and subscribe. Be sure to leave a comment with whatever tutorial you'd like to see next, and I'll see you in the next video.